Good morning, students. Welcome to the lecture of Operation Research. In the last lecture, we have seen how to solve a rectangular game by using the linear programming problem. For this, we have seen a fundamental theorem of rectangular games that if mixed strategies are allowed, then there always exists a value of a game. What is the meaning of mixed strategy? Actually, here we want to find out the probabilities of playing the strategies by every player. Okay, it is not guaranteed that the player is playing only one strategy at a time. It may play all the strategies with some different probabilities, and those are called as the mixed strategies. In the previous lecture, actually, we have seen this theoretical aspect, how that given rectangular game can be converted to a linear programming problem. Correct, no? This is what equivalence we have studied. Equivalence between rectangular games and linear programming problem. In order to find out the equivalence, we have used a criteria of finding maximum of minimum expected gain with respect to player A and minimum of maximum expected losses with respect to player B. And very nicely, the equivalence between a game theory and the linear programming problem was mentioned. And if we just observe both the types of linear programming problem constructed, solving with respect to player B is more easier. Why? Because the objective function is maximum and constraint is of less equal to, right? Therefore, here also we have seen one example, and the LPP we have constructed is with respect to player B. Before that, we have calculated the min, max, and maximum values. And with this, we can easily check whether a given game has a saddle point or not. If it has a saddle point, there is no question to discuss. But for without saddle point, we will find out maximum and min max values, and we will check whether the value of game can take a possibility of a zero or a negative value. If so, we are going to add a suitable constant to all the entries of a pair of matrix so that value of game could not be zero or negative. Once we add, it will be my new matrix, pair of matrix. Then we have written the LPP with respect to player B. This is the LPP. While writing this, we have to construct the constraints using the rows. That is, the first row will be, first constraint using first row will be 8y1, 4y2, and 2y3, which is less than or equal to 1. Second is 2y1, 8y2, 4y3 less than or equal to 1. y1 plus 2y2 plus 8y3 is equal to 4. And once we construct the linear programming problem, easily we can solve it. Once we solve, we will get the values of capital Y1, capital Yi's. Then using the relation between small yi and capital Yi, easily one can find out the values of small yi's and the value of game as well. Right? And this is what the LPP with respect to A I have shown you. And I told you to solve this also. Have you solved it? This one? Actually, this while solving this LPP, as the constraints are of greater equal to 8, one has to use either big M, two-phase or dual circuit. I hope you have solved it. Now let us go to the next point today. Yes, any difficulty up to this before going to start the next point of the syllabus?
No, ma'am.
Good. Now in today's lecture, we will go for a new point of solving the game called as the arithmetic method. What is arithmetic method? But this is only for the games of order 2 by 2. Arithmetic method for 2 by 2 games. Without saddle point. 2x2 games without saddle point. What is the meaning of 2x2 game? Yes? Anyone from student? 2x2 game? Hello? Students, what do you understand by 2x2 game? What this is actually 2x2? Is it the order of our payoff? Right?
Yes, ma'am.
If it is the order of payoff, what is the meaning then? How many choices or how many strategies both the players will have?
Ma'am.
Hello? Hello? Yes, students, how many strategies each player will have?
Four.
Each player has four strategies. Each player, I must say.
Two strategies, ma'am, each player.
Yes, two strategies each player. Okay. And as there are two strategies to each player, it will construct a payoff matrix of order 2 by 2. So whatever this arithmetic method we were going to study, it is only for 2 by 2 games, which is not having the saddle point. And there is one theorem given on this. Let me write the statement of a theorem. Theorem says that, show that for any zero-sum 2-person game, where optimal strategies, are not pure strategies. What is the meaning of not pure strategies? There is no saddle point, correct? No, because if it has a saddle point, what is the meaning? Optimal strategies are given, right? No, where we know exactly which strategy both the players is going to select for the optimum gain or optimum loss. Therefore, pure, not pure means mixed strategies. It actually means that there is no saddle point, and for which the player is payoff matrix is okay. Let us write the payoff with respect to A. Generally, we were writing with respect to A only, correct? Okay. Probabilities. Let me write 1 to 2. Player A. What are the probabilities for player A? We were writing x1:2. What will be the probabilities for the player B? We were writing y1:2. Let me write the entries of the table v11, v12, v21, and v22. And optimal strategies are determined by What is the meaning of optimal strategies actually? Find out the probabilities of the strategies played by the both the players, that is x1, x2 and y1, y2 are determined by here first let me write for player A, that is x1 by x2 is given by v22 minus v21 upon v11 minus v12 y1 by y2 is equal to v22 minus v12 upon v11 minus v21, and the value of game, the value B of the game to player A is, this is given by V equal to V11, V22 minus V12, V21 divided by V11 plus V22 minus v12 plus v21. These are what the values actually. What is x1 by x2, y1 by y2? And actually we were going to calculate x1 separately, x2 separately with using these formulas. Okay. But one may think, you know, finding these values of the variables x1, x2 and the value of game may be difficult for us because one has to remember the formula. Actually, there is no need to remember these formula. These formulas can be remembered with a simple trick that was given by an algorithm that we will discuss later. First, we will try to understand how these x1 by x2, y1 by y2 are values are determined. Okay. Now let us proceed to the proof. In the proof, what we were going to discuss actually, our aim is to find out the optimal strategies of both the players. Optimal strategies means actually we were interested in finding the probabilities of activity 1 and 2 with respect to player A. Similarly, probabilities y1, y2 while the player B plays activities 1 and 2 respectively. So finding optimal strategies is actually finding these probabilities x1, x2 and y1, y2. And finally, we have to find out the value of a game. Now, as there is no saddle point for this game, what we have discussed in the previous lecture, that player A is going to maximize his minimum expected gain, and player B is going to minimize his maximum expected losses. Right now, the word expected we were using. Okay, let me just recall you. This is B, this is A. These are the strategies 1-2, 1-2 played by both the players. Then first we will find out the minimum expected gain. Okay, minimum expected gain. And then we will try to maximize the gain. Similarly, here we will find out maximum expected loss. And then we will try to minimize the maximum expected losses. This is what an idea is. Now, what we know how to find out the minimum expected gain with respect to player A. If B chooses first strategy, we will find out the minimum gain. Similarly, we will find the minimum gain if B chooses second strategy. Can anyone tell me what is the minimum expected gain for player A if B chooses first strategy? We have discussed many 3-4 times I told you how to find out minimum expected gain. Do anyone remember this? Yes. I hope I am clearly audible to everyone. Hello.
Yes, ma'am.
Let me tell you again. The minimum expected gain for a player A, we were writing, if B chooses first strategy, the minimum expected gain is this entry, this payoff into its corresponding probability. So this, the first one is V11 into X1 added with this second payoff entry V21 into its corresponding probability. This will be the minimum expected gain of a player A if B chooses first strategy. Similarly, if B chooses second strategy, what will be the gain? This is V12 into X1, V22 into X2. Correct? And among both this, player A 12. Yes? Player A 12.
Maximize.
Yes. Let us write. Let a mixed strategy for player A be given by x1, x2. That is, we are writing the probabilities. Just wait a minute. everything is erased. I don't know why, but let me just rewrite the statement. I'll just write the values of x1 by x2, okay? And then afterwards I will write and complete and I will share it. X1 by x2 is 222 minus 341 upon 311 minus 312. Y1 by y2 is 3 1 1 3 2 2 minus 3 1 2 3 2 1 divided by 3 1 1 plus 3 2 2 minus 3 1 2 plus 3 2 1. Okay, now we were going to write the minimum expected gain with respect to pair A. I think pair of matrix you can remember. With probabilities x1, x2, player B playing 1, 2, with probabilities y1, y2, the entries are v11, v12, v21, v22. Probabilities here are y1, y2. Therefore, we were writing the mixed strategy for A. Let the mixed strategy for A is given by, that is, we were writing the probabilities of activities played by the player A, where, and as these are the probabilities, one may surely know some of the probabilities is 1. Okay, now what we will go for finding? Yes, expected gain of A if B chooses first strategy. Okay, and time being, let me write this as E1 of X. What we have discussed, this is V11 X1, V21 X2. V11 X1 plus V21 X2, right? Similarly, expected gain, here also let me write, expected gain of player A if B chooses second strategy. If B chooses second strategy, what is the gain? Let me write it as P2, P2 of X. What's the second column entries? Go to your second column now, right? No? What are the second column entries?
V1 to X1 plus V2 to X2.
Yes, V1 to X1 plus V2 to X2. Okay, now not what we were writing, player A want to maximize, but player A wants to maximize, player A wants to maximize his minimum expected gain. Minimum expected gain. Okay. That is. Okay. Whatever is the value of a gain, both those values are greater or equal by V. Is it okay? Player A want to maximizes minimum expected gain. Okay, therefore the value of game must be minimum of these two, na? Minimum of E1x and E2x. Correct or no? What is the value of game? This is minimum of e1x and e2x. If the value of gain is minimum of these two, one can write e1x is greater equal by v, e2x is greater equal by v. Okay. Therefore, thus player A will find out, thus player A how to find x1, x2. Player A has to find x1, x2, x1 greater equal by 0, x2 greater equal by 0, such that. What such that? What is value of e1x? V11 x1 plus V12 x2 and is greater equal by, oh sorry, this is 2, 1, no? Greater equal by V. What is e2x? This is V12 x1 plus V22 x2 is greater equal by V. Okay. Is it okay? Minimum expected gain. Player, whatever the player A want to do, he want to maximize. Therefore, this value of gain must be minimum of the two values, e1 of x and e2 of x. And value of gain, if it is minimum of these two, it has to satisfy the relation. e1x is greater equal by v, e2x is greater equal by v, and here we have written. And one can impose one more condition that x1 plus x2 is equal to 1. x1 plus x2 is equal to 1. And for optimal strategies, for optimal strategies means, if once we find out the value of x1 and x2 such that this is exactly equal to value of gain, this is exactly equal to value of gain, then this greater equal inequalities becomes equal to. Therefore, one can write for optimum strategies, for optimum strategies, let me write this about equation. About inequalities becomes equations. About inequalities becomes equations. I hope you are understanding this. Okay. For optimal strategies, I am writing. For optimal strategies means the exact values of x1 and x2 for which max min is equal to min max is equal to v. Therefore, this is actually max min and which must be equal to v. Okay. Here I can write a small hint for you. Max min equal to min max equal to v for optimal strategies. Now we were writing for optimal strategies itself. Therefore, max min, min max, both must be equal to v. Therefore, here whatever this inequalities we have written, those will be the strict equations. So, v11 x1 plus v21 x2 equal to v. V12 x1 plus v22 x2 is equal to v. And with this third one as it is, we will have that x1 plus x2 is equal to v. Okay.
Ma'am, your mic is off.
Okay. Now, what is our job? Our job is to find out the values of the variables x1 and x2, which is going to satisfy these three equations. Let me call the equations by some number 1, 2, and 3. Okay. Now, I think one can easily solve this. First, what we will do? We will subtract 2 from 1. Subtract 2 from 1. What will happen if I subtract 2 from 1? We will get V11 minus V12 into X1 plus V21 minus V22 X2 is equal to, yes? 0?
Yes, ma'am.
Then what is the value of X1 by X2 which we want to find in the theorem itself? What is X1 by X2? This will I have to shift on the right with a negative. If let me change the sign. V21 minus V22 minus V21. This will be shifted to the denominator. and that is V11 minus V12. Is that okay? The same we want to prove actually. 2 minus 2, 1, 1 minus 1, 2 minus 2, 1 upon 1, 1 minus 1. Is that okay? But with this ratio, we are unable to find out the values of x1 and x2. But to find out the exact values of x1 and x2, we will try to solve these three equations for x1 and x2. For this, what I will do? I will just substitute the value of x1 or x2 calculated from this ratio. This ratio time being, let me call it as say 4. Okay. Now what we will do? We will substitute x1 in terms of x2 in equation number 3 and we will try to solve. Okay. Therefore, what will be the value of x1 in terms of x2? Let me shift x2 on the right side. This is V22 minus V21 upon 11 minus 12 into x2. Put this value in. Put this value in 3. Right? What is 3? x1 plus x2 equal to V. x1 plus x2 equal to 1. So let me just substitute the value. x1 I have to substitute. V22 minus 21 upon 11 minus 12 x2 plus x2 equal to 1. Okay. Now we will take x2 common. What is remaining with us? 1. So V22 minus V21 upon V11 minus V12 plus 1 equal to 1. Let us make an addition first. What this addition gives us? V22 minus V21 plus 11 minus 12 divided by 11 minus 12 equal to 1. Is any term going to cancel? No. Right? So what is the value of x2 we will obtain? 11 minus 12 upon 22 minus. So we will take positive terms together. What it will be? 11 plus 22, V11 plus V22 minus negative terms we will put in a bracket. V12 plus V21. Okay, this is what the value of x2, let me call it as statement number 4. How can we obtain x1 then? Let us put this x2 back. Let us put this back in this equation, or one can put it in 3 again. Okay. Let me put it in 3 itself. Put x2, put 5 in 3. What's 5? x1 plus x2 equal to 1, na? Is that correct? So this is x1 plus x2. I have to substitute 11 minus 12 divided by 11 plus 22 minus 12 plus 21 and is equal to 1. So let us just simplify to find out the value of x1. This is 1 minus 11 minus 12 divided by 1. But let us just have a cross multiplication. Which terms will get cancelled? 11 and 12 will cancel. No? And we will remain with what? Will I write it everything? Okay, V11 plus V22 minus V12 plus V21 minus V11 minus V12. Denominator will be as it. Check which terms cancel, plus V1 minus V1, right? Okay, this is minus V12, this is minus of minus plus V12. Therefore, we remain with x1 equal to, yes, V22 minus V21 upon same denominator as of in x2. Okay, what are the values of x1, x2 we have obtained? Thus, optimal strategies are x1 equal to v22 minus v21 upon this, or one can write it like this also. Okay, v11, let me write minus v12. These are first row entries added with v22 minus v21. These are second row entries. Therefore, it will be easier for us to remember. What is x2 we have obtained? 11 minus 12 divided by, same I will get, v11 minus v12 plus v22 minus v21. Okay, look at, if you look very carefully, this and this bracket is same, this and this one is same. And what about the denominator? V11, V12. Therefore, we have to take the subtraction of first row elements. This is also a subtraction of second row elements. And we have to add. Okay, and correspondingly, we have. Therefore, finding this, writing this formula is not a difficult task actually. One can easily remember this. Is there any difficulty for the values of x1 and x2? Now the job we have to do similarly is to find out the value of a game. Okay, how to find out the value of a game? We will put both the values. Here if we observe, equation 1 and 2 are giving us the values of game. So we will put the values of x1 and x2 in one of the equations. Right? Therefore, put x1 and x2 in one of the equation. Say I am putting in 1. Is that okay? What's the one equation? V11 x1 plus V21 x2 equal to V. Okay, let me write V equal to that, because we are finding the value of V. What is V11 x1? X1 is 22 minus 21. And the denominator is V11 minus V12 added with V22 minus V21. So the value of x1. Now let me put x2. What is x2? 11 minus 1. And same denominator. Okay, now let us just try to simplify. Let me simplify. As the denominator is the same, we have to just do addition of numerators. In book, the denominator was written like this itself, okay? 11 plus 12. But here I have written in, for the sake of our convenience. This is just for sake of our convenience while solving the example. Both are having the same value, right? Okay, which term cancels or not cancels? Let us do a multiplication. V11, V22 minus V11, V21 plus V21, V11 minus V21 into V12. Middle two terms will get cancelled, correct, no? And we will remain with the first two terms only, first and last term. Therefore, for cancelling these two terms. This is V11, V22 open. Is that okay? This is what the value of a game is. Therefore, if we just observe, the optimal strategies x1, x2 are depending on the values of entries of the payoff matrix. Similarly, value of game is also depending on the entries of the payoff matrix. Now, this is everything we have calculated with respect to player A only. Now, similarly, one can calculate with respect to player B. Okay? Therefore, in the similar manner, in the similar manner, for the player B, optimal strategies are Φ1, Φ2, satisfying the following relations. Now, what is the following relations? Now, I am going to write the relations directly. Satisfying following relations. Now, what player B is doing actually? Player B is doing finding the maximum expected losses. What are the maximum expected losses of player B if A chooses first strategy? This is V11, Y1, V12, Y2. Right now? Now we were writing row wise. So here I will write E1 of X is the symbol we have used. Now let me write E1 of Y. What is the value? V11 Y1 plus V12 Y2. Similarly, what is P2Y? This is V21 Y1 plus V22 Y2. Now what player A is going to find? Maximum loss. Therefore, actually the min max value we want to find out, but before that, for the optimal strategies, value of game is equal. Or if I want to find out the maximum expected losses, then maximum among these two will be equal to the value of game. Right? No? Is that okay? If what we want to find out, which inequality it will satisfy then? Thus, I can write V11 Y1 plus V12 Y2 is less than or equals to V. Because maximum of them, both of them is going to be, give me the min max value, that is value of game. Is that okay? And Y1 plus Y2 equals to 1. Again, for optimal strategies, for optimal strategies, above inequalities becomes equations. We are not going to write in detail, okay? I am just carrying out. Above inequalities become strict equations. What will be the equation? V11 Y1 plus V12 Y2 equal to V. V21 Y1 plus V22 Y2 equal to V. And Y1 plus Y2 equals to 1. Same three equations we have obtained. Okay? And then again subtracting and all, we will get thus. What is Y1 by Y2? Let me do a subtraction of these two equations, right? I think, what are the numbers? It will stop at 4, I think. 5. Let me call this to be 6, 7, and 8. If I subtract this 7 from 6, 6 minus 7 gives me y1 by y2 equal to what it will give us? v22 minus v12 upon v11 minus v22. Is that okay? And again repeating the same, putting the values of finding y1 from this, put it in 8 and all, the optimal strategies we will write. What are the optimal strategies? y1 equal to. I think you can repeat if you want. Denominator we will get like this. And what for y2? Value of y2 is v11 minus v21 upon same denominator. Okay, and value of gain. What is value of gain? Value of gain v is equal to 1122 minus 2112 divided by v11 plus v22 . If you just observe the value of gain obtained from both the equation 1122 2112, numerator I must 1122 2112, denominator is no doubt same. That is, value of gain is going to remain the same in both the cases. Only the job is to find out the optimal strategy, that is the value of the probabilities x1, x2 and y1 value. Okay? Understood the theorem?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, and this theorem or this formula works only if x1 by x2 and y1 by y2 both are positive and will give the acceptable value. This is what a simple restriction is. Okay? Here we will write, if ratios x1 by x2 and y1 by y2 are both positive, these will give acceptable values. Acceptable values of x1, x2, y1, y2. Correct, na? And if the ratios are not positive, what it will give us? See, if I look at this ratio x1 by x2 obtained in this, where it is? Yeah, here it is. If this ratio is negative, what does it mean? One of the values of the variable x1 or x2 will be negative. And as we were writing, x1 and x2 are the probabilities, both the values should be non-negative. Therefore, this solution is acceptable only if these both the ratios, x1 by x2 and y1 by y2, will give us the positive values. Otherwise, not. And this is the small restriction on the arithmetic method. This is the small restriction on the arithmetic method. Okay. Now, this is what the values we have obtained. Some big formulas you may think of. But this is very easy to remember as a trick. Therefore, let me give you the arithmetic method. Some simple trick to remember the formulas. Arithmetic method. Okay, what this algorithm says that step one, we will find out the difference of two numbers in column 1, put it under column 2. Find the difference. Find the difference of two numbers in column 1. In column 1 and put it under column 2. treat under column 2, neglecting negative. Okay. In the step 2, what one has to do? Similarly, we'll find the difference of two numbers in column 2, and we'll put it in under column 1. Find the difference of two numbers in column 2 and put it under column 1. Again, that neglecting the negative sign. Okay, now in step 3, what we have to do? Repeat the same step for rows also. Repeat the above steps for 2 rows also. Okay, and the values thus obtained are called as augments. The values thus obtained are called augments or means. Augments is actually the probabilities or the frequencies. Okay. Now, if we do this, it will be easier for us to solve the example. Okay. Suppose the example was given us to find out the optimal strategies or solve the game. I'll just say solve the game. And what is the game given? Some player B with 2 activities, player A with 2 activities, and the entries are 8 minus 3 minus 3, 1. 8 minus 3 minus 3, 1. Okay, what the steps says to us? Make the difference of 2 numbers in column 1, put it under column 2. Right, na? What is the difference of 2 numbers in column 1? 8 minus of minus 3. 11, let me put it under column 2. Difference of 2 numbers in column 1, minus 3 minus 1 is minus 4. But neglecting negative, it will be 4. I have substituted both the values in column. Let us repeat the process in rows. Let us find the difference in first row elements, 8 minus of minus 3, 11. 11, I have to put it here. Minus 3 minus 1, 4, minus 4, let me write plus 4. Okay, these are the values we have obtained, right? These are the values we have obtained. Then what we will find out? We will find out the optimal strategies x1. Okay, what is the optimal strategy x1 will be? Optimal strategy x1 will be 4 upon 4 plus 11. 4 upon 4 plus 11, that is 4 by 15. What is x2? X2 is 11 upon 11 plus 4. That is 15 upon 15. Sorry, 11 upon 15. Okay. Similarly, what for y1? Y1 it is 4, same it will be there actually. This is coincidence. Okay, now why we have done this? Now we have to just make a correlation between the values, right? I will write the formulas and I will tell you why this example we have solved like this. Later I write x1, x2 first. What is x1 we have found? what is x2? Now we'll create the simple trick. Okay, now the job we were doing is find the difference of first column and put it under second, v11 minus 21, right now? Difference of second. Similarly for rows, similarly for second row. Okay, now check what is the numerator of your x1. These are the values of x1 we were writing. What is the denominator? You can check. We were neglecting the negative sign, we were taking only positive values. Therefore, this sum is nothing but your denominator, no? 1, 1, 1, 2. If I just neglect this sign, this is V22 minus V21. Okay, this will be the addition. Only numbers we are discussing. Okay, these two numbers, addition is there in the denominator. Similarly, here also, whatever we have written will be the addition. Right now, actual denominator is going to be same. What is the numerator of x1? X1 numerator is V21 minus V22, neglecting the negative sign. The numerator of X2 is 11 minus 12. Therefore, here in the example, we have written 4 upon the addition as X1, 11 upon the addition as X2. Okay, same criteria we have followed for Y1. For Y1 also, if you can check, I have to write y1 value also here. What is y1 we have obtained? What is y1 now? Check numerator of y1. Numerator of y1 is 12 minus 22, neglecting the negative, you are saying. Neglecting the negative, this is the same. For y1, we have written this upon the addition of the 2. Correct, na? Similarly, y2, we have written 11 minus 21, this upon the addition of 2. This is the simple trick, short trick to find out x1 and x2. Is there any problem? Is there any difficulty? Let me repeat the example. Find the difference of two elements in column 1, put it under column 2, neglecting the negative. Similarly, do it for column 2. Find the difference of column 2 elements and put it under column 1. Okay. And then, similarly, we have to repeat it for rows. We'll find out the difference of two elements in row 1. We'll put it in under row 2. And similarly for row 2. Next, x1 we will find out this number upon the addition. X2 is this number upon the addition. Y1 is this number upon their addition. Y2 is this number upon their addition. This is what, according to the formula, we have calculated as a simple trick. Okay, and similarly, one can find out the value of a game as well. Okay, but this arithmetic method has some restrictions. There are two restrictions. First, it can be used only for 2x2 games. Secondly, this is important. These ratios must be positive. Then only the values of x1, x2 gives us the acceptable values. Okay. Understood the arithmetic method? If you have any difficulties, you can ask me. Actually, one has to recall these formulas. And then only you can understand this. A trick it was told to us, right now? Otherwise, you may forget the theory, and if you want to solve in the exam, you just remember this, what I told you. Find the difference of two numbers in column 1, put it under column 2. Find the difference of two numbers in column 2, put it under column 1. Similarly, do it for rows, and the values can be obtained like this. The value of x1 can be obtained. Here x1, it is there, no? Okay, but x1 is obtained by 4 upon the addition. X2 is obtained by 11 upon the addition. Similarly, what about y1 and y2? Y1 is obtained by this number upon their addition. Y2 is obtained by this number upon their addition. Both the values are not necessarily equal in every case. So by chance, these two values are equal. Is it okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Any difficulty? If you have, you can ask. Otherwise, in the next lecture, we will go for a next method to solve the paper. If not, let me stop for today. Thank you for being with me for this today's lecture.